which has been long in the planning and a rapid rehearsals and everything else, because they've been doing so much work about World War II. It's difficult to know when to start living your life. But they've had a couple of weeks, so thank you very much for all your efforts at home. I know I've been a bit pressurised, but not as much as pressurised as Mrs. Cannon's felt, doing it pretty much on our own due to lots of factors this year. So thank you very much for all the children who put all your effort in before you start. And thank you for all your efforts that you put in, sending in costumes and etc. just in case I forget anything. So we're here to enjoy this afternoon. Fire alarm plan. The will here.
To the bravery courage, you will laugh and you will cry.
So history is wartime memories. The hopes and fears, the joys and tears of the people, just like you and me.
I am speaking through the cabinet room at 10 Downing Street. This morning, the British ambassador in Berlin handed the German government a final note, thinking that unless we heard from them by 11 o'clock, that they were prepared at once to withdraw their troops from Berlin, a state of war would exist between us. I have to tell you now that no such undertaking has been received, and that consequently this country is at war with Germany.
But for a long time in Britain, nothing happened at all, so we can't even call you up.
This is horrible!
You watch your manners, Granny made that.
We'd be glad of it with the rations of him.
Russians, Russians, where?
Not Russians, Granny, rations.
Hey, everyone, get up. Fred got the cake to make him another his gas mask.
You're shivering yourself, Fred. How did you write what came?
Don't be too hard on your dad. It's not as if there's been any really useful discussions yet. Might as well.
that we lead them to the nearest shelter. If they haven't answered, they should go there. If they complain, even if they complain, and some of them will, we insist, after all there's
a war on. Yes, we know.
Well, I've got to hear it. Right, Smith, you look after Dean Street. Bendel, you look after Hampton Road.
Thank you. George.
That's right, sir. Just let Jane Chester get past it. Oh, I'm fine. I'm just get this thing.
Well, let's hope Jane will just not have until the afternoon. Then.
So, one that you can probably use on the mountains. I don't fancy placing that to go to the
room. Ah, why would the German soldier be going to the room?
This is no time to be joking around. We will be provided with the necessary equipment in due course. Until then, we must improvise. Now then, for the important secret mission we are undertaking later today.
Later today? Oh, I'm afraid. I can't. My back is just as long as I am, I think it's going to be. Maybe we can rearrange it for later in the night.
Absolutely not. Our vital work cannot and will not be performed to allow me domestic chores or other such trivial reasons. Jerry could attack at any time. Well, that can't help. Now then, we're patrolling the local area, removing road signs. If Jerry invades, we need to make it difficult for him to... Oh, hello, Ben.
There you are. Should've been home 10 minutes ago. Please get the frying pan. Shall I tell you why I said it? Except because you're playing soldiers instead of the queue for the bacon at lunch, like soldiers
do. We have a secret.
Hold, now.
Grab him to eat. We'll show us a secret.
Now.
Thank you.
moment for them to send a letter home, if you know what I mean.
Hip hip!
Hooray!
more slavery in the factory. Alice and Fred sent hundreds of miles away. And of course, there was a brave group of soldiers in case his granny truly awful homemade soup.
Come on, Edith. Time to go. Oh, don't forget Tuffy. And don't forget your scrapbook.
Yeah.